a great experience. Thank you guys for all the support you give your kids, because it's a lot of money. A lot of money. And part of it, too, I know, is to get recruited. And we all know that when paying, there's some clubs out there that pay $25,000 a year just in dues and not even including their travel. There's a couple teams here this weekend from Texas that, anyone from Texas here? Okay. I can say this. They're crazy.
I'm from Texas. Just
for you guys to be here and spending the money that you are, again, if your kids don't stay, it's you. Shame on them. Shame on you for not making them do it. But thank you for what you guys do. There's also other big tournaments going on this weekend. And I don't know if you guys, anyone went to Vegas? I know there's somebody that was here that went to Vegas. Denver? Salt Lake? Where else is there red so far this year? Phoenix, Kansas City's coming up. Yeah, and there's Omaha.
Omaha.
Yes. So think about all those tournaments. It's a lot of them, right? And now you guys are here for a very small qualifier. It's a really small qualifier, which is why we get teams like a lot of different teams in clubs that maybe not the top teams, because I think everyone can qualify here. It's just a smaller national qualifier. It's growing and it's great. We're getting a lot of great coaches here now. A lot more college coaches from all over the country are starting to come out, which is great for your athletes. It's awesome. But I want you guys to think about this. The weekend of President's Day, which was a 3-day weekend, there was Vegas, Omaha, tournament in Phoenix, a tournament in California, a tournament in Salt Lake City, a big one in Chicago, a big one down in Orlando, amongst other ones. It's a lot of athletes. How many coaches did you guys see? Probably a lot. But just think about those coaches and where they're all spread out, all over the country. But also think about the number of those girls out there, like at the West, out there, at all these different tournaments. Those are a lot, it's a lot of level players. A lot of level players. And the biggest thing is when coaches are going to these tournaments, they have a list already made of who they have to go see. They have their list. Like, I have my list for this weekend of athletes. You're one of them, or your daughter's one of them, that sent me a scouting form to be recruited and evaluated. I've got my list. Those are my priority kids that I'm going to go see. If you want to get on that list, you can fill out a pink sheet, and I'll be happy to see your daughter this weekend. But those coaches have those lists already made, and those are their top priorities. Maybe something attracts them and says, I've got to go watch this kid. It says she touches 10'5". She's top priority. I'm going to go watch that kid. So making sure that your daughters are on those lists of college coaches that they come to these tournaments, especially tournaments like qualifier here, PNQ, that we have the Hub 20 miles that way, Convention Center here, and then Eastern Washington, another 20 miles away. They have to go, and if it's worth their time, then they might go travel to those distances. You know, Cheney to the Hub is quite a ways away. It's annoying. I know it's annoying for them to go have to get their car and go somewhere else. It totally is. Or they're going to stay in one place and just see those athletes. So, again, getting on that list is important. I've totally gotten off track already.
Well, while you're on that, what are the other ways to get on that list?
I'll go over that. Absolutely. So, I'm going to talk about real quick the different divisions, kind of the benchmarks, the scholarships. Benchmarks, like what they're looking for from the athletes to play at those levels. And then some other things to go along with this. And I'm going to throw out some numbers. Has anyone sat in one of my seminars, either in Vegas or Denver? No? Okay, good. So, these numbers, you don't have to write them down. And then I'm going to come back and they'll all make sense. Okay? So, Division 1 volleyball. It's like your Gonzaga. Okay. Washington State, University of Washington, University of San Diego. Big schools. But not necessarily big, right? Gonzaga has about 6,000 students. But they're still Division 1. So, to be Division 1, it's the amount of sports teams that are in a program. Okay? Division 2, like Western Washington, has like 25,000 students, but they're D2. So size of the school does not matter whatsoever. It's the amount of sports programs that athletic department has. Okay? Division One has up to 12 full ride scholarships to give. There are 5 sports that can give a full ride or nothing. Volleyball is one that can give a full ride or you're a walk-on. You don't get any money. So, Division One volleyball, 12 full ride scholarships. There are 327 Division One programs in the country for a total of 3,924 full ride scholarships. Again, you have 100% down. I'll come back to it. If your daughter has high academics, and this goes across the board for every single division out there, high academics makes your child more recruitable. No ifs, ands, or buts. Your kid, unless she's 6'8", left-handed, and a setter, is a dime a dozen. A dime a dozen. There, that you don't see. You don't see a lot of those out there. But you do see a lot of 6 feet tall girls. It is so common. You walk into these tournaments, you're like, oh my gosh. And the coaches see these parents, go, where's your daughter? Like, I'm following them around. That's how you get on the list, too. Right there. Walking the stilts. So, where was I going with that? Oh, your academics are really going to be something that adds to your recruitability. Okay, if they see on an email that you send out, you have a 2.2 GPA, bye-bye. Just not going to do it. Because there's so many 4.0 and higher student-athletes out there that want to go play Division One volleyball, but they're able to go and just get picked up. So those schools can be really picky on their GPAs. Plus, if your child is available for academic money, because it's her grade, obviously academic, then she is going to save that athletic department money. She won't see that $10,000 academic scholarship that she's being awarded, but the athletic department will, because that's $10,000 they now don't have to take out of their budget for that child, for that athlete. Okay, so their academics, not yours, their academics really play a part in how recruitable they are. GPAs, SAT and ACT scores, really important. And I suggest, I even tell my freshmen that I work with, start taking your SATs and ACTs. Start now. The score doesn't necessarily matter. At the end, they're going to take the best scores and bunch them together, and that's going to be your ending score when you submit it to colleges. So, practice makes perfect, right? You don't know what you don't know. When your child is able to take those SATs and ACTs, they understand what they're good at, what they're not good at, they're better prepared. Then they keep getting them more and more academic money. So it's important, it's early on. And there's some people that say, you got to junior year, start taking them. Why me? Go start taking them now. And you can start understanding what it's all about. Okay, so, yeah. Question is, do they have to do both? No, you can pick one, but they might find that if they do the SAT, they might test better in the ACT. So then focus on testing the ACT. So the school will take either one. Okay, so that's a great question. All right, so if your daughter is a sophomore or younger, she could have only received one letter so far from a Division I school from the athletic department. Just one. So if she gets written freshman year, she cannot receive another athletic letter from them until September 1st going into her junior year. From that same school. So Gonzaga writes your daughter last year, or this year as a freshman, she won't hear anything again. Unless it's a camp invite or something from admissions. Totally fine. Which, trust me, when I was over there, we really liked a kid, and it wasn't, we already sent that letter, it's, hey, admissions, can you send this packet off? Can you do this? Can you make sure that she's still liking Gonzaga? So there are ways around it. Thank you. You guys, parents, kids, you guys can make a phone call to them anytime. You guys can write them anytime. And I'm just going to keep using Gonzaga. So you can write them, call them, anything you want to do. They just can't return a phone call, and they can't write you back. Who they can write back is your coach, your high school coach, someone like me, somebody that represents your daughter. They just can't talk to you guys. But if they are to answer their office phone, then you can have a conversation with them. Trust me, I had phone calls from parents that said, my daughter is 5'5", she's a middle, she can totally come in the WCC. Excuse me? No, she can't. She can't. I love my son. You love your daughters. They're all the greatest, right? They're not all Division I. They're not all Division I. And that's okay. That's a job. And those athletes, here's a quick little benchmark. Is your daughter able to touch the rim? Can she touch the basketball rim? And play front row. Back row, your guys, those kids are exempt from the actual jump touch. But a lot of Division I schools are looking for those athletes that can touch 10 feet over. Setters, 9-6 and over. Because they have to be able to walk, right? So, your daughter's at 9-9. My friend that coaches at University of San Diego, he says, yeah, I'll entertain an athlete that can touch 9-9, 9-10. But she has to nail every serve receive pass. She has to play phenomenal defense. She has to be creative at the net to get around block, tool blocks, you know, find the shot, hit heavy, all those things. They'll still look at an athlete that's touching that. So 10 feet isn't the only number and can't do it. If there's other things that they look at, that's just a good, easy, benchmark for you guys to think about for Division I. You guys can, your daughters can take unofficial visits to programs all in any level. You guys can take an unofficial visit. An unofficial visit is on your dime. You go to campus, somehow you get in contact with the coach. If you're a junior, and you email and they write back or text you back or call you back. A visit can be set up on your own dime. So an unofficial visit, your kids can take as many unofficial visits as they want. Starting June 15th, before your official visits, that's the first day of your senior year. So when your daughter reaches senior year and she starts her first day of class, that is when a program can actually fly her out for 48 hours and be on campus and pay her way. You guys, if you want to tag along, it's on your dime. But they can fly your kid out the first day of class for senior year. She gets 5 official visits for the Division I school. That's it. Now, let me throw this little fact out there. There are 8th graders verbally committing to Division I schools. A verbal commitment is something that you guys, your daughter, can make to a college coach anytime. It doesn't happen that much for Division I their senior year. They're going to be committing sophomore and junior years. It happens that early. It really happens that early. Things happen last second where coaches are saying, we just lost somebody, injury, pandemic, family emergency, she had to go home, now we're scrambling to find somebody to fill in. Those things happen, but you don't want to have to wait that long to get on those lists. And it happens in Division II and Division III of NAIA. There's still even sophomores that commit to NAIA schools. But there are 8th graders and 9th graders that verbally commit when a coach says, hey, we've got a scholarship for you in 2019, we'd love to have you, great, yes, I love your school, I commit, and then you're done with the recruiting process. Until that coach leaves the school, and then, oh my gosh, what if the new coach coming in doesn't like me, then you're looking all over again. Because until you sign on the dotted line, and the early signing date for Division I is November of their senior year, so if you commit as a freshman or sophomore, anything can happen. And injuries can happen. I mean, anything can happen. So make sure when you guys are on these trips, a little free piece of advice, go walk around the campus. Take your daughter, go walk around the campus. Walk around Eastern's campus. Go up to Whitworth. About 7 miles up the road is a Division III school that's beautiful. Whitworth. It is gorgeous. Go walk around. Go have your kids feel the different environments. Right now, our women are playing across the street, hosting the NIT, first NIT. What a vibrant experience. What a great, it was boys' basketball, holy cow.